U.S. Army selected Bell's V-280 Valor Tiltrotor as future long-range assault aircraft to replace UH-60 Black Hawk. After a thoroughly strenuous and lengthy period of flight tests spread over several years, the Army has chosen Bell's V-280 Valor Advanced Tiltrotor to replace the venerable UH-60 Black Hawk helicopter. The future long-range assault aircraft, Valor, is set to enter service in the mid-2030s. Bell beat out Sikorsky in Boeing's Defiant X compound coaxial helicopter based on Sikorsky's X2 technology. While somewhat stingy on the specifics of why the Army chose Bell's Tiltrotor over Sikorsky's pusher-compound-rotor design derived from the company's X2 technology, Barrie said the decision boiled down to a best value proposition. Can we be more specific on the factors of how exactly we arrived at this point? No, Barrie said. However, best value is meant in the truest sense that it was a comprehensive analysis of a variety of factors. No one really drove that decision. So, if you look broadly at a very high level, the factors are variables and performance, cost, and schedule, all were considered, and the combination of those are defined explicitly and evaluated. That is what I would describe as the best value. And what the Army would describe as its best value selection. The award is a huge win for Bell. The company recently completed planned deliveries of the latest versions of the venerable H-1 family of rotorcraft to the Marine Corps, built the OH-58D Kiowa Warrior that the Army retired years ago, and, with Boeing, developed variants of the V-22 Osprey for the Marines, Air Force, and Navy. This is an exciting time for the U.S. Army, Bell, and Team Valor as we modernize the Army's aviation capabilities for decades to come, said Mitch Snyder, President and CEO of Bell. Bell has a long history supporting Army aviation, and we are ready to equip soldiers with the speed and range they need to compete and win using the most mature, reliable, and affordable high-performance long-range assault weapon system in the world. Both teams delivered their specific pitch for future long-range assault aircraft in September of last year. The Sikorsky Boeing Defiant X is a refined version of the Army's Joint Multirole Technology Demonstration Program, in which the Valor was its prime competitor. Valor posted hundreds of flight hours in its flight test campaign and notched more than the 280 knots speed it was named for and designed to achieve. Conventional helicopters cannot get anywhere near that speed. In fact, the V-280, which is a demonstrator and not a finalized design for the Army, broke the 300-knot barrier in testing. Valor's first flight occurred on December 18, 2017, and has since logged more than 200 hours in the air and met a number of ambitious speed and agility goals set by the Army under the Joint Multirole Technology Demonstration Program. V-280 improved upon the Bell-Boeing V-22 with its tilting nacelles rather than the V-22's tilting engines. In many ways, this win gives Bell a chance to improve upon its tiltrotor technology, with the V-280 specifically designed to leverage lessons learned by developing and fielding the Osprey and the hundreds of thousands of hours flown by the type in some of the world's harshest conditions. Maintainability and affordability are very much design drivers for Valor. The Defiant team released a statement following the Army's announcement. We remain confident Defiant X is the transformational aircraft the U.S. Army requires to accomplish its complex missions today and well into the future. We will evaluate our next steps after reviewing feedback from the Army, the companies said. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.